I wanted to start on this video premise and do things a little bit differently when it comes to E3 2018. Everyone is doing the routine formal review on every conference, but I felt this year that is a bit redundant after doing so many live reactions and putting in so much work on that. Again, click on the video playlist below to check out our E3 2018 live reactions. That being said, let's keep in mind that this will be a top 10 list. So I'm thinking top 10 no-shows at E3. Keep in mind, there's always next year where some of these games could pop up and they could get the spotlight. However, I'm going to try to focus on the games that could have significantly improved certain conferences this year. Number one is the Final Fantasy VII Remake. With the notion that Square Enix was going to have their own separate press event, we figured it would be substantial in its own regard. Translation, it wasn't. It was super shallow. I'm not sure why the Final Fantasy VII Remake was absent, especially during a time where Square Enix needed it the most. It's double irony when both the Resident Evil 2 remake and the Final Fantasy VII remake got announced in 2015. One game is showing more progress, the other game has been a no-show this year, scrapping CyberConnect 2's assistance. I'm hoping after the dust settles, we'll see more FF7 next year, even if Nomura is too busy being a workhorse, working on two projects simultaneously. At least we got Kingdom Hearts 3 to look forward to in 2019, so that will serve as compensation for the lack of Final Fantasy VII Remake. Next up is number 2, the new Splinter Cell game. From constant teasing of wanting Sam Fisher to come back, either by references in Ghost Recon Wildlands, endless interviews, or just noticing the current void of the stealth genre, it felt like E3 2018 was going to be Sam Fisher's year. Sadly, it wasn't. Splinter Cell was a no-show this year, and what we got was a pretty mediocre fare for Ubisoft. Splinter Cell was among the list of the Walmart leaked listing, and I guess it was Assassin's Creed Odyssey that took front and center this year. Admit it though, you missed those three-eyed green goggles creeping around at night and you wanted Sam to take another shot at a new release sooner or later. Number 3 is Metroid Prime 4. I'll cut some slack here that this game was announced last year, so it was a year of nothing. The game probably is in early development. The confirmation itself, either by JPEG or whatever means, is enough to get fans giddy, but the lack of news has been a bit disappointing. They could do something with concept arts, developer videos, maybe releasing an early beta of a stage or something. Something should be released eventually to keep the fans enticed next year and to make sure to let everyone know this game is on the right track. I guess now would be a good time for Nintendo to capitalize on re-releasing the Metroid Prime trilogy and making this re-release prevalent on the Switch. Number 4 is Bayonetta 3. You knew it was coming, another game that was heavily anticipated, revealed last year and not really touched upon for E3 2018. I guess Bayonetta 3 gets off the same hook as Metroid since they're probably still in early development, although it would have been nice to see some small progress here or there, some small touches. Nintendo Direct's E3 was essentially Smash Ultimate being touched upon for half an hour, and that was it. I need some of that wish time in my life. Number 5 is Blue Point Games and their next big project. Blue Point Games announced that they were going to work on something that's bigger in scale, even bigger than Shadow of the Colossus. After the finishing touches was put upon for the Shadow of the Colossus remake, Blue Point was sadly absent during Sony's E3 2018 conference. It's been speculated upon that what Blue Point could be working on in various videos. A lot of people say it's going to be a Metal Gear Solid 1 remake, which would be nice, but until we get full confirmation, we're stuck scratching our heads as to what it could be. Maybe they will reveal it at E3 2019 or PlayStation Experience 2018. Next up is number 6, Rocksteady's rumored Superman game. It's been rumored upon for a long time that Rocksteady was making a new video game and that it was in the works for years. Majority of the rumors speculated that it would be based around a new game centering around the Man of Steel, but there's no official confirmation if it will be a Superman game or not. I will say if it is, the possibilities are endless. Let's be honest, Superman doesn't have the greatest track record in video game history. Superman 64 is a flaming pile of manure fuck that shouldn't exist and is known to be one of the worst video games in history. Rocksteady taking the mantle would not only set the internet ablaze for Superman games, but the company would have something to prove, especially after the notion that there hasn't been a good Superman game in years, and Rocksteady is just coming off the successful Arkham franchise. Could Rocksteady pull off a Superman game and make it good? Well, we definitely didn't find out at E3 2018. An apology was issued for not making the show by Sefton Hill himself, one of the co-creators behind Rocksteady Studios, citing that they were not ready to unveil this project to the public eye just yet. Number 7 is Square's new Avengers project, another game that was announced last year that could have greatly benefited the lackluster Square Enix E3 2018 presentation. I'm afraid Earth's Mightiest Heroes were a no-show at this event. We don't know any sort of indication of how this game will play, so what kind of game we have on our hands here hasn't been really illustrated that much. After all, this is the second biggest Marvel game to come out after they found a new lease on the gaming climate with Spider-Man on PS4. You would figure this is kind of a big deal to see how this turns out with fans. We're hoping for something unique considering how there's so many diverse playstyles with each Avenger, and hopefully that turns out to be a great gameplay experience. Number 8 is Borderlands 3. I never really played any of the Borderlands games. I'm sorry. I'm sure there's an audience for them, but Gearbox was largely absent at E3 2018, and so was this game. Number 9 is Konami themselves. Oh, Konami. Oh, joy. Fuck Konami. While Konami is still holding on to a major fucking L after Metal Gear Survive, and while any Pacific games aren't really on my mind when it comes to what they could have shown here, they were a no-show at E3 2018. At least we didn't see them there talking about stupid shit like PES or something irrelevant like pachinko machines. So Konami, fuck you. Make some good games, make a resurgence, come back like Capcom did. That's all I ask. Make Metal Gear great again, make fucking Silent Hill great again. I'm tired of you guys putting out patchy slot machines. Sell your IPs, shit, or get off the pot. Number 10 is Watch Dogs 3. After the Watch Dogs series slightly redeemed itself after Watch Dogs 2, I played the beta a little bit, I enjoyed it. But it was decent, and it seems all the leaks that came out prior cited the game was inadvertently confirmed, and it appears that Ubisoft wasn't quite ready to spill the beans. So we don't know if there's going to be any phone hacking hijinks until the year is over. This is Renegade Operative signing off. Hopefully you guys enjoyed my video on the top 10 no-shows of E3 2018. Leave a like, thumbs up, subscribe, do whatever, fight in the comments. No, don't do that. Just leave your comments on what you thought about the video. I'll get back to you. Let's discuss, let's interact, and let's see if you agree. What games did you want at E3 2018 that weren't touched upon? I will see you guys later. Peace out. Also, I guess Shenmue 3 definitely is an honorable mention. Holy shit, I can't believe I forgot that. Top 11, motherfucker. Top 11. No, it's top 10. Top 10, bitch. Top 10. But Shenmue 3. I need some gameplay in my life, fam. Come on.